I'm Markelle Welcome to UDUB. Welcome to UDUB. Welcome to UDUB.
Capital Hoops out here at University of Washington with Ebony Fultz. Ms. Fultz, it's been a while since we talked to you, but
yes.
Markelle's story has blossomed quite a bit since the last time we talked to you.
Uh-huh.
I know you've made a lot of trips out here to Washington to support Markelle and University of Washington basketball, but just your general thoughts on how his career and his, you know, just everything is going out here.
I think it's going good. We haven't quite had the season we wanted to have, but in spite of that, I still think it's going good. There are a lot of lessons to be learned through wins or losses. He's come out here and he's shown me how mature he is. He's taken the bull by the horns. He's been very responsible. He's been very motivating to his teammates and the coaching staff, very supportive. And I think it's been a really, really good experience for him.
Outside of basketball, tell me how you think Markelle's getting along with just the adjustment of being in a totally different culture,
mm-hmm.
you know, on the West Coast, where just things are a lot different in general.
How's
that going for him?
I think it's going well. Markelle's always been one to adjust very well to different situations and different circumstances. Everybody speaks so highly of him, from the ushers to the teachers. You know, I haven't heard a bad thing about Markelle. They just talk about how humble he is, how good of a kid he is, how helpful he is. So I hear that a lot. And as a parent, it's refreshing to hear that.
I know it's a very crazy time for you, Markelle.
Yeah.
What are you trying to instill in him? As there's obviously a bigger picture down the road, but he needs to concentrate on what he's doing right now. How do you, like, when you talk to him about, you know, kind of living in the moment and not thinking forward too much,
yeah.
just tell me about those conversations.
Just tell him the same thing that I've been telling him since he was young. You know, you have to handle the business that's here and now today. And when we get to the next step, we'll handle that accordingly. Just to focus, have fun, but play hard, work hard in the classroom, and just live now and enjoy now before you're thinking about the next step, so you don't miss something in this here and now.
All right. Well, Ebony, we thank you so much for your time. It was great to see you again, and I'll see you down the road.
All right. Thank you. We'll be right back.
talked about at halftime, about guarding against that, that this game wasn't close to being over. But we did come out flat and turn the ball over far too many times. In the beginning of that second half, we turned the ball over 5 times in the first 4 minutes, and that kind of set the tone. But while that was going on, we weren't active defensively. It was a bad combination. We fought back. We ended up taking the lead again. Went up a couple of times, but didn't finish it. But now we've had 2 games in a row where we played well. They didn't finish.
What do you think was so hard about trying to get the offense going in the last 5 minutes there?
I think we had turned the ball over so much, we were a little tentative out there. We began to settle for just 3-point shots. That made the difference. SC has good length, great anticipation, great athletes. And they're quick to the ball, and they get in those lanes. And a lot of passes that have been getting through, weren't getting through tonight, they were getting their hands on it. And that can start to play on your mind. And last few minutes, that seemed to be on our mind, where someone might be open. We were a little tentative in making a pass.
I'm happy that back in 3-pointer, cut it to 1, it's less than 2 minutes left. It can seem like it's anybody's ball game at that point. Yeah.
I think it was 74, 71 at that point. We weren't able to get a stop. I forget who it was that scored at that point, but when the last few possessions, we just didn't dig in and get grimy. Make the plays that were necessary to win the game.
Coach, is there anything in particular that you can do as you guys go down the final stretch of your season to help close out games that maybe you haven't been able to do in some of the more recent ones?
The answer is to win a few so that we can believe we can do it. You got to win one. And how do you do that? You got to make the right plays down the stretch. You got to take care of the ball. You got to make shots. You got to get stops. You got to make free throws. Arizona game, we didn't make free throws. You got to do those things. The last 5 minutes of a game, you have to get stops. You can't turn the ball over. You got to make your free throws. If you do those 3 things, you have a good chance to do all right.
You guys are obviously going to make mistakes of inexperience and, you know, missed assignments and missed shots are one thing, but does it baffle you that you can describe your team as flat in the second half when they're up 10 against a team, the kind of team that they haven't been able to beat this year?
Does it baffle me that we were up like that, or that you could come out flat?
That you would come out flat in a situation that you haven't been in with a chance to get a win like that?
When we were in the locker room at halftime, I would say we were feeling pretty good about ourselves. Too good. We obviously didn't understand that much more work was going to be required to come out on top.
Coach, can you talk about the way Markelle closed that first half? He had that chase down block, then he hit 2 threes, and I think in the final 45 seconds of the half.
Markelle being Markelle, making big plays. He got it going from 3. I think he was 4-for-4 in the first half from 3-point line. That was good to see.
Do you think the rest of the team was looking for him to put on a similar performance towards the end of the second half? Do you think they were leaning a little bit too heavily on him, perhaps?
No. You know, there we go with that question again. Why doesn't Markelle take over at the end of the game? Well, were they depending too much on Markelle? No. It wasn't that. We became tentative. We settled. We weren't determined to get the ball inside, to drive the ball inside. We weren't determined to do it. We just settled.
Anything else, guys?